Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm Rumela and in today's video, I'm going to share with you guys some skincare tips. Now, these are the skincare tips that I have learned through my experience of having a skincare routine and just taking care of my skin in general. These are not just some tips that I read over the internet and I thought of sharing it with you guys. These are my real life experiences and I have learned through these tips. I want to just share those tips with you guys and I'm also going to share my morning skincare routine along in the video as we go through the tips. That is the topic of today's video. Also, I wanted to give you guys a little bit of life update because I haven't been very, very consistent. The last video I posted was, I think, 10 days back. But I was in Bombay and I was alone with Inaya. So it was a little difficult for me to film a lot because obviously I had to take care of her. But now that I'm back in Pune, I'm hoping to film a lot of videos for you guys. Also, with my new camera, I can bulk film and edit whenever I don't have time. So I'm really excited to film really good content and I'm also going to come up with a lot of food vlogs and all of that. So I'm really, really excited for all the content that is going to come up. So that was a little bit of a life update. So without making the intro any more longer, let's dive straight into the video. Okay, so the first step in any skincare routine is obviously a cleanser, and in the morning I like to use a really nice mild, mild gentle cleanser because I don't have any makeup on. So I don't need to get rid of anything. I just need to get rid of the products that I've applied in the previous night from my nighttime skincare routine. Thoda sa product rehta hai and then there's a little bit of dirt from the pillows or somewhere on the bed. So that is the only thing that I have on my face. So I just need to get rid of that, the dirt and the products. And I really like to use a gentle cleanser. I really love using the Nivea Milk Delights face wash. That is very, very gentle and it cleanses the skin really well. Also, it is it does not foam up a lot, so it is very, very suitable for sensitive skin as well. They do have a lot of variants, but today I'm going to use the Cetaphil Gentle Skin Cleanser. Now I used to use this a lot back in the day when I had really bad acne. This is what my dermat had recommended to me and I used this straight for 2 years and I used to love it back in the day, but then I stopped consulting the dermat and then I got other face washes and I used those. But now that I'm back to using this one, I absolutely love it. It's been only a couple of days that I'm using this and I really, really, really love this. So I'm just going to dampen my face a little bit and then go in with the cleanser. Okay, now coming to the skincare tips, the first skincare tip that I have is to have a skincare routine and to stick to the skincare routine. For the longest time, I think I did not have a skincare routine until like 2 years back, and now that I have a proper skincare routine and I stick to it, my skin has never looked better. So it's very, very important to have a skincare routine that you will stick to. Don't be overwhelmed by so many products that are there in the market and then buy all those products. Like if you see an influencer doing like 11 step Korean skincare routine or a 20 step skincare routine, and then we get really intrigued and then we go ahead and purchase all those products and we don't stick to that. We'll just do it for a week and then forget about it. That is not something that you should do. You should have a very minimal skincare routine. Just use products that are really that would really be effective on your skin and that would target the issues that your skin is facing, and stick to the skincare routine. Now no skincare routine or skincare product will magically change your skin in just a week or even 2 weeks. It takes a minimum of 4 to 6 weeks for any skincare routine or any product to show results on your skin. Like to show the tiniest of results, it takes that much time. You will have to do the skincare routine for at least like 4 to 6 months for you to see like visible changes. So make sure you stick to a skincare routine that you can do in the long run and follow it religiously, and you will definitely see a difference in your skin. So I'm just going to wash the cleanser off and be right back. Okay, so my face feels really clean and also feels really soft. I really like how hydrating this cleanser is. Now I'm going to apply some rose water from the natural wash. I'm going to, you know, take a quick little shower in this and then we'll move on to the next point. You know, until this dries up, we will talk about some other skincare tips. The next one that I have here is to hydrate your skin in and out. And by hydration, I don't mean just drink water, consume foods that are high on water content, and keep your fluid intake high. I know it's not possible for everyone to drink lots of water, so just make sure your fluid intake is really high. You can have flavored water or lemon water and all of that, and also fruits that are high on water content, fruits and veggies. And coming to hydration, on the outside you can apply topical creams. Now make sure that your moisturizer has emollient, humectants and occlusive. Now humectants will trap moisture from the draw moisture from the surrounding and hydrate your skin. And then occlusive will trap the moisture into your skin, and emollient will help your skin stay really nice, supple and bouncy. So make sure that you have all of that in a moisturizer so that your skin feels really nice and hydrated. And then you can use hyaluronic acid, that is really good for hydration. You can use aloe vera gel. Aloe vera gel is also really good for hydration and for soothing. And you can use glycerin as well, that is also really good for hydration. So make sure you use all of these products so that your skin stays really hydrated from in and out. And hydration is the key to really healthy looking skin. If you have dehydrated skin, your skin will look, you know, dull and pigmented, and it will not look the best. So make sure you hydrate your skin as much as possible. I'm just going to pat the rose water into my skin a little bit, and I feel like the rose water has settled really well. Coming to the next point is know what your skin needs, and you know, have a skincare routine according to what your skin needs, because there are hundreds and thousands of products in the market, and it's very easy to be you know, really overwhelmed by all these ads and go ahead and buy those products and it will not suit your skin. Now if you have acne prone skin and you buy products that are you know, not the best for acne prone skin, they are like really hydrating and moisturizing products, and they will, you know, they are well suited for dry skin type, but just because they are marketed really well, you go ahead and buy them and it will not suit you. So make sure you use products that are meant for your skin type and issues that your skin is facing. Don't go ahead and buy products just because they are trendy or a lot of people are using it and all of that. You know, this is a very, very important point to keep in mind, because I have been there. I went ahead and used products that were recommended to me by other people just because they had a different skin type, they had a different issue, and the product worked really well for them. But when I used it, it caused really bad acne and breakouts for me. So this is a tip that I have learned. So I always make sure that I use products according to my you know, issue. Now I have a little bit of a pigmentation here around my mouth and also on my cheek area, so I use an alpha arbutin, and I use hyaluronic acid as well because I suffer from a really dry skin. So alpha arbutin and hyaluronic acid works really well for me because that's the issue that my skin is facing. Now if I go ahead and use salicylic acid, or if I go ahead and buy niacinamide, that is not what my skin is facing right now. So this is a very important tip to keep in mind. The next step in my skincare routine is using a serum, and this is the vitamin C serum. I like to use my vitamin C in the daytime, and I like to keep it in the black carton that it came in, because vitamin C does tend to oxidize when it is exposed to light. So I like to keep it in the black carton in my drawer so that it does not come in contact with light. Coming to my next point is to use your water-based serums or moisturizers on damp skin. Now using products on damp skin really works well. With this vitamin C, it foams up a little bit when I apply it over damp skin, so I don't do that with vitamin C, but with alpha arbutin and with my moisturizers, I make sure that I apply them on damp skin, and it works really well. The skin absorbs the product really well, and it has a lot of benefits. So make sure you use all your water-based serums on damp skin. So I'm just massaging the serum on my face and it gives a very nice glow to my skin. I absolutely love this serum. If you are a beginner and if you're looking for a good vitamin C serum, I would definitely suggest the Minimalist Vitamin C Serum. I forgot to show it. This is how it looks. It is a 10% vitamin C serum, so it's very, very suitable for beginners. Don't go ahead and use a 20% vitamin C if you're a beginner. It will cause purging and it will not suit all skin types, so start slow. Which brings me to my next point, is to start slow when you're using actives or any product in your skincare routine. Make sure you start slow, make sure you use the least amount of product, like the least percentage. If you're using retinol, start with 0.025% and all that. Like if you're starting with a chemical exfoliator, make sure you use like a 5% lactic acid, a 10% lactic acid. Make sure you start slow and then you can build up on the tolerance. The same goes with AHAs, BHAs, retinols, any actives. Make sure you start really, really slow. The next tip I have here is to introduce actives in your skincare routine in your early 20s, like when you are 21, 22 is a good age to introduce actives, and make sure you use actives that are catered towards your skin issue, as I said already. Like alpha-butin works on pigmentation and niacinamide works on acne and acne marks. Then there's salicylic acid that works on blackheads, whiteheads and acne. Then there's AHAs work really well on texture and pigmentation and all of that. So use actives that are catered towards your skin type and introduce them in your early 20s. If I knew this, I would have definitely done it, but when I was 21, I did not have this much knowledge about skincare, so I did not. I started using actives when I was 25, that's like 2 years back. And my skin has looked so much better than what it was before. And another tip I have here is to introduce retinols in your late 20s, like when you're 28 is a good age to start retinols. But retinols are not recommended for pregnant and breastfeeding women. If you are pregnant or breastfeeding, just stay away from those. Since I am breastfeeding, I am not using retinols right now. I plan to start retinol in my skincare routine once I wean Inaya off breastfeeding. So that is that. The next point I have here is to get into chemical exfoliation by the age of 22-23, and again start slow. Chemical exfoliation has changed my skin like nobody's business. Trust me when I say this, my skin has started to look so much better since I've introduced chemical exfoliation. But again, start slow. I started with the 10% AHA BHA serum from Dot & Key that worked really, really well for me, and right now I'm using the Minimalist 30% AHA BHA. But again, start slow and don't use too much of exfoliator. I am not saying that physical exfoliators are completely bad or you should not use them. They are a little harsh and they can cause micro tears in your skin, which is very, very harmful in the long run. So if you are using a physical exfoliator, make sure that you're very, very gentle. You're using the lightest amount of pressure, and if you can, then definitely get into chemical exfoliation. It will change your skin. So that was another point. Now coming to the next step in my skincare routine is a moisturizer. The one that I am currently using and loving is the Earth Rhythm Phytoceramide Moisturizer. This is such a good moisturizer. It is a very, very thick, so it is meant for normal to dry skin type, and I absolutely love it. It makes my skin look really nice. It makes my skin look very naturally healthy, and that is why I love this moisturizer. Okay, coming to the next point is don't overdo anything. Like don't overwash your skin, don't over exfoliate, and don't over mask. And the same goes with under washing. Like don't underwash your face, under exfoliate, and by that I mean don't wash your face like 4 times a day, and don't not wash your face at all. Like don't exfoliate every single day and don't not exfoliate at all. Keep a balance. Make sure if you're using a physical exfoliator, make sure you exfoliate like once a week, and with chemical exfoliators I think once in 2 weeks is good. if you're using a very very mild chemical exfoliator, then you can do it like once a week. And the same goes with face masks as well. Don't, you know, use a face mask every single day. If it's a store-bought mask or homemade masks also, don't use a face mask every single day. And the same goes with washing your face as well. Like, don't wash your face so much that it will, you know, become dehydrated and it will strip your skin off of its natural oils. And, you know, just keep a balance is what I want to say. Don't overdo or underdo anything. That will really ruin your skin in the long run. Now coming to my next tip is to apply a sunscreen every single day. Now if you are someone who uses actives, then you have to apply a sunscreen every single day no matter what, and reapply your sunscreen every like 3 to 4 hours if you are indoors. That's enough. And if you're indoors, you can just apply an SPF 30. If you are outdoors, you can apply SPF 50. I have my favorite sunscreen recommendations on my channel, and I will link that in the iCard, so you can go check that out if you are on a lookout for a good sunscreen. But make sure you apply a sunscreen every single day. It will really protect your skin, because sun's rays are really harmful. They not only tan your skin, they cause pigmentation, they cause dark spots, wrinkles, and they also cause skin cancer. So it's really really important to protect your skin really well. The last step in my skincare routine is obviously a sunscreen. So today I'm going to use the UV Duo sunscreen. This is something that I absolutely love. This is such a matte sunscreen, and also it has silicones in it, so it will also act as a primer. This is very very matte, super matte. So if you are someone who has oily to combination skin and you sweat a lot, then this is a lifesaver for you. Try the sunscreen out and you will not regret. This is not something I use when I'm indoors, like not on a daily basis. I use the Pond's one or the Episoft one. I cannot find the Pond's one anywhere because I just shifted back to Pune from Bombay, and I'm just unpacking everything and I just cannot find the Pond's sunscreen anywhere. But that is what I use on an everyday basis, or the Episoft one. The Episoft one is something that I've loved, and I've used tubes of it. Like I think I've used 3 to 4 tubes of it, and I absolutely love that sunscreen. It is so good. Again, it has minimal white cast. Even this one has a minimal white cast. Okay, coming to the last point, that is do your nighttime skincare routine at least 2 to 3 hours before you go to bed. Now if you are someone who has a full-fledged nighttime skincare routine, which I highly suggest you should have, do your skincare routine 2 to 3 hours before you go to bed, and let the products sink really well into your skin. Because if you just apply the products and go directly to bed, the products will transfer onto the pillow and it will not have your skin will not be able to reap the benefits of all the products. So that is one tip. The last step in my skincare routine is to obviously apply a lip balm. I am a lip balm addict. I love to apply lip balm, and I have a lot of lip balms, but the one that I'm currently loving is the Plum Candy Melts lip balm. This is something that has a very nice tint to it, and in my morning skincare routine I really like to apply tinted lip balms because it also looks really pretty and keeps your lips really moisturized. This one is really nice. It is kind of thick, but it is also not very heavy, so I really like it. It moisturizes the lips also really well, so this is what I am currently loving. So that is it for the video, guys. That was my morning skincare routine, and those were all the tips that I wanted to share with you guys. I hope you guys found the video helpful, and I hope that these tips come in really handy for you guys. If you found the video helpful, then don't forget to give it a big fat thumbs up and also subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. I'll see you guys very very soon in my next video. Until then, bye bye.